take every man jack of you.
She only ever feels like shagging. Don't lift a finger round the yard.
Stay out of my way.
Your mug just ain't like any I've ever seen.
Everyone to me! To me!
Greetings again. So, you got a job for me, an interesting one.
Show me what you have in stock. So long.
Best way's this side of the Ponton.
So bored I can scream.
Eternal fire, walk with you.
What's going on, everybody? SwiftBoy 3000.
This the Brasotti Brothers Auction House?
Seems it.
Continuing our Witcher 3.
Need I remind you?
Walkthrough.
Fraternizing with civilians is not allowed.
Welcome to the stream.
Just curious. Redanian Army regulars, right?
Lance Corporal Vaclav reporting. And this bloke's my subordinate, Private Kleiner.
Careful you don't piss yourself out of excitement.
You say something, soldier.
Not a thing.
Shouldn't you be somewhere? There's a war on, you know.
We was transferred here. All official. Written order 76CWX. Mission, guard the auction house. Priority, high top, in fact.
Borsodi fella knows his way about the court. Helps the high ranking sell their war booty. Gets protection in return.
Private Kleiner, that's confidential military information.
Any of the owners home?
Meaning the one and sole owner, the esteemed host Bisodi? Aye, he is.
Need to talk to him.
Order 76 CWX is clear. Auctions only open to folk with invitations. Writ out in their names, plain and simple.
Gonna let that hold you back? Come on.
Afraid you're out of luck. Order 76 CWX also held that Lance Corporal Vatslav stick a broomstick up his arse.
Kleiner, need I remind you of the penalty for insulting a superior?
Who have we here? Geralt, the Witcher of Rivia.
Vimy Vivaldi, the banker from... Actually, where are you from?
Matters little, mate. Gold knows no boundaries. What's all the fash, Corporal Vatslav? Are you squabbling with my pal Geralt?
Master Vivaldi, sir, your esteemed associate, he weren't invited to the auction, and I've...
But I plough and have been, and he's coming with me. In you go, Geralt.
But my orders...
Fuck your orders! Need I take this up with the sergeant? Ha! I thought not. Now, stand to attention and shut your giggy.
True. Tell him what it is, dwarf.
The lads will be rolling back at the barracks.
Sucked it. Now march. Round you go. One, two. One, two.
Appreciate the help.
Just note, I've always had a mind to seeing two old pals and clients.
Business with you's a pure pleasure, Vimy.
The dear departed wifey claimed the same. Ah, folk are assembling. Auction's about to start. Time we went upstairs.
What did folk come to bid on? Any idea?
All kinds of valuables. Rare weaponry, exotica. But I've got my eye on a selection of canvases by the master portraitist of the Maribor School. Van der Neuve and Longendijk.
Well, well. Never knew you to be a connoisseur.
Of course I'm not. It's all muck and rubbish to me. Point of fact, I'll just wrap them in paper and lock them in the vault.
Why in the world do...
What do you mean, why, Geralt? I've got to diversify my investments, didn't I?
Could have sworn the Borsodi's auction house was in Novigrad.
It was, but they moved it. You see, Radovid offered Horst a preferential tax rate. 0%.
Pretty much unbeatable.
Aye. And I've nae seen a purer example of the benevolent state.
Actually, I'm really just here to talk to Horst Borsodi.
Oh, might be more of a problem than you'd expect.
Because?
An awful hermit, that one. Not a wee bit like his da, Militale keep his soul. But Horst would like to show his heed during the auction. I'll introduce you then.
Be mighty indebted to you.
Think nothing of it. Only have a collect on loans and promissory notes. All right, up we go.
Pagé egg, white gold, and mother of pearl with topaz incense. Sold to
Geralt, you thought of buying real estate. Could get you.
I'm going to take the moment to tell you guys that Royalty Gamers is having a giveaway, as you've heard in the last episode. Please go to www.facebook.com/royaltygamers for your chance to win a standard edition Black Ops 3 copy for Xbox One, Xbox 360, PlayStation 4, PlayStation 3, and PC. Whoever wins gets to pick their system. And I would like to say good luck to you all who enter in the giveaway.
If terms on a mortgage.
No such thing as attractive loan terms, Vimy.
What about in Kaveri marks?
Come on. You know damn well that makes no sense.
Auction won't start for a time yet, it seems.
Vimy, This is a banquet.
Aye? And?
I detest banquets. Vacuous conversation, food portions fit for a mouse, drinks that taste like piss.
Ah, they won't all be bad. Let me introduce you to some of my most interesting associates. Old hen there is Countess Mignol. Wager you'll have plenty to blather about with her. Prick in the corner's Hilbert. New coin, that one. Came into a right fortune playing Gwent. Ah, there's Yaramir, art dealer. A purer snob I've never known. But he knows paintings like no other. So, ready to chat someone up? It's not fitting for us to stand here like knobs.
Who should I talk to first? Let's talk to the old lady.
Greetings to the Honorable Countess. Madam, allow me to introduce my dear friend, Geralt of Rivia.
Witcher of the School of the Wolf.
Forgive me, but have we had the pleasure?
No, but your guild is unmistakable. Your medallion.
Take note, Geralt. Countess Mignol is an eminent collector of Viriminaica.
What now?
All manner of objects related to the witcherly profession. Swords, gear, medallions.
Mind if I ask how the Countess became interested in us humble monster slayers?
I've some pleasant associations, dating from my oh-so-distant youth.
Dinna you say such things, Countess? You look right fetching to me.
That's very kind, Master Vivaldi. But apart from my Vedamaniaca, I also own a number of mirrors.
Your most prized piece. What would it be?
An armor element. An antique. School of the Wolf. From 1234.
Classic. Is it up for sale?
I fear not. It's a memento. One of great sentimental value.
But perhaps the Countess has got other Witcher curios she's willing to part with. Or acquire. Perhaps she could trade. I'd charge 5%. A modest, transaction fee.
Sure, why not?
Vimy, never seen anyone so good at laying their mitts on coin that clinked within earshot. But what the hell? See if we can't make a deal.
I think I buy all of it. Might as well get some Viper gear.
Does the Countess have her eye on anything particular today?
No, but Horst Borsodi insisted he would put up something that would be of interest.
Did he happen to say what it was?
No. Oh, you know what he's like. A walking enigma. On another topic. Master Geralt, I was wondering if you'd be willing to help a lady in need.
Depends on the nature of the need.
Oh, it's quite the trifle. I stepped out onto the balcony a moment ago. I dropped an earring while there. I couldn't find it. It must have fallen through the floorboards. Perhaps you, with your cat eyes...
Not a problem.
Sure, I'll look for it.
I shall be much obliged.
See you in a minute, Vimy. Some spilled wine. Nothing else. There's no earring out here, is there?
None.
Maybe the Countess would care to explain what this is about, all jokes aside.
Forgive me. God, this is so embarrassing. Do... Do you know Vesemir? He was a tin shorter than you, wore a mustache.
Do I know him? Man taught me everything I know.
What? How is he? If you don't mind my asking.
Don't mind at all. But before I answer, I also wouldn't mind knowing how you knew each other.
Oh, I've told no one. Not ever. But I suppose I owe you an explanation. It was the winter of 1234. A beast prowled the streets of Oxenfurt. A fledder, I believe. A contract was issued, a notice posted, and a witcher appeared. Vesemir, of the school of the wolf. He came through our estate, tracking the beast. Our eyes met. Something sparked. I wrote him a message, asked my governess to deliver it. He visited, under the cover of night, night after night. On one such occasion, my father heard something. Vesemir had to flee. So quickly, he left behind his gambeson.
Ah, the first piece. The start of your collection.
Yes. But also the end of our love. Father had an arrest warrant issued, then quickly married me off. I was fortunate. My husband died young, leaving me a sizable fortune. And thus, I have lived on memories.
Afraid I have bad news.
Oh? Please tell me, did he at least die like a witcher?
No. He died like a hero.
There is that. I thank you for tolerating a decrepit madwoman so elegantly.
Please don't say that.
I am old and I am wealthy. I may say what I please. And now, be so kind and leave me to my thoughts.
Aww, that's so sad. I miss Vesemir. He was a good witcher.
Many tales.
Funny! Duke Clivet declared bankruptcy, and that ring on his finger. Shite!
Let's talk to this guy.
Halbert, it's been years. Allow me to introduce you, Geralt of Rivia.
Enchanted.
Pleasure's all mine.
How's it? Got your eye on any sparkly bits today?
Not really. I buy what strikes me fancy. I need something right sumptuous for me walls just now. Nilfgaard. I get it right.
Excuse me?
You're Gwendec. It's Nilfgaard, isn't it? Come on, admit it.
I don't really like Gwent.
Seen right through me.
I knowed it. You don't look like one who easily agrees to a draw.
You ought to know, Helmut. Geralt here's a positively superb player.
No, I'm not.
Superb.
He's a liar.
A minute before the auction starts, so... Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. Maybe around?
Maybe another time.
Sorry. Another time, maybe.
It is what it is. I'm off for a nosh. By the by... Watch those little black balls. Strange, them.
Ah, to spurn the caviar of the Kaviri sturgeon. They're casting pearls before swine. Come, Geralt. Let's have a blether with another.
Yeah, sorry, guys. I'm not really a Gwent player. Let's talk to this guy.
Yaramir. Might we trouble you a wee spare?
Mm-hmm. Greetings, Vivaldi. Who's this?
Geralt of Rivia, Witcher.
I thought you might have a blether with us. About the paintings on the block today.
Ah, sniffing for a quick turnaround as usual, are we?
Pot calling the kettle black, I'd say. Do a lively trade in canvases yourself, my friend.
True. Yet first they delight my eyes, whereas you treat them as mere promissory notes. The only arts that interest you are those culinary. What about you, Witcher? Do you know anything about paintings?
A bit.
I realize this might be hard to believe, given my crude-looking mug. But yeah, I know a thing or two.
Truly? We ought to see what. Do you know our friend Vivaldi is in possession of 5 canvases by Van der Nobe? Yet he cannot distinguish them from landscapes at 5 crowns apiece.
I shan't pretend it otherwise.
Yet for you, my dear connoisseur Witcher, that should present not the slightest problem. So do tell, which of these is the handiwork of Edward Van der Nobe, the master from Marip?
Okay, I really don't know. I don't know which one to pick, because I really don't know.
Novigrad, I'd say.
There's not a bumpkin who does not know Van der Nobe, never ventured outside Maribor. Adieu.
Got that wrong.
What a jackass.
Yeah, fuck him. Typical Arister cunt. I've grown accustomed.
Oh well.
Huh. Esteemed ladies, honorable gentlemen, the auction will begin shortly. Take your places, please.
Ah, at long last. Come with me to the fore. I won't see much elsewise.
Oh well.
Vimy, listen. Forgot to ask you, how's this auction going to work?
They'll bring out 3 lots to start with. Once they've sold, or not, there'll be an intermission. Horst Bosodi will probably appear then. That's when I'll introduce yous.
Counting on it.
In the meantime, have you got a budget? You prepared to bid?
Should I bid on something?
Of course I will. Went to the trouble to sneak me in here. I'd be an ass not to take a stab.
Ha! Knew the bug would get you.
Depends on what's going on for sale.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. I hereby open the auction. Ladies and gentlemen, lot number 1 is a brass figurine from the collection of the infamous Count Romilly. Rumor has it, the figure harbors a treasure inside. A rumor one may prove or disprove solely by destroying the beautiful bauble itself. Starting price? Quite the bargain at 50 crowns. Any advance? With Master Hilbert at 100. To Countess Mignol, now at 150. Do I hear 200? Might I have an advance?
Screw it.
The white-haired gentleman enters a bid of 200. Do we have 250? 200 once? Twice? Thrice? Splendid, Countess Mignol bids 250. Do I hear 300?
300. What'd you guys think? Fuck it.
My, my, this is lively. I've 300 going
That's
once.
That's the last time I'm bidding, though.
Do we have 350? 300 thrice. And sold to the white-haired fellow. Lot number 1, the mysterious brass figurine. Proceeding now to lot number 2. A canvas by the young Novigrad artist Van Roe. Starry Night over the Pontar. Charming piece. Truly a bargain at 20 crowns. Ladies and gentlemen, 20 crowns. It's practically naught. Good folk. Is no one tempted? Atypical in style, true, but worthy of the vestibule, surely. Do I hear 10 crowns? A mere 10. Ah, at last, the buyer. 10 crowns, once, twice, and going thrice. Lot number 2, Starry Night over the Pontar, sold to Master Yaramir. Lot number 3, ladies and gentlemen. A true rarity, scarce as hen's teeth, spectacles. A frame of gold, mountain crystal lenses polished by the tiny, dexterous hands of the gnome masters, once the property of the famed hired assassin known as the Professor. Starting price of 200 crowns. Anyone tempted? Gwent Maestro Hilbert offers an advance of 50. Do I have 3? My, haven't we livened up?
Mm-hmm.
300 from Yaramir Ivanovich Zaitsev. Going
300.
Once,
looks
twice.
Like people want this. Let's do 350.
Incredible. With the white-haired gentleman now, good folk, at 350 crowns. A generous offer indeed. Any advance? 350 going once? Going twice? Sold! Invaluable spectacles to the white-haired gentleman. Exceedingly glad they'll be useful. May they serve you well, sir. Oh, the excitement. With the 3 lots behind us, we'll go to an intermission. Amenities abound. Please partake. We'll resume shortly.
Oh, spend some money on some items. I wonder what they do.
Sudi, come on, before some other cocksucker steal him. Just, well, don't expect a warm welcome.
Don't expect a warm welcome. Must be a jerk off.
Allow me to introduce a dear friend and associate, Geralt of Rivia, who
comes uninvited.
Exactly. Pretty serious oversight. I see no reason why the faux pas should taint our newfound acquaintance.
Acquaintance? I honestly don't know what you think this is, Vagrant.
Got the distinct impression the two of yous started off on the wrong foot. Perhaps we should raise a toast to...
What's one like you want from one like me?
Right, let's dispense with the niceties. Maximilian Borsodi's house. Gotta lay my hands on it, whatever it...
What? Where did you learn of it?
Gentlemen, no reason to lose our composure. Raise our voices.
I ask you, where did you learn of it?
Whoa, come on now.
Where?
Doesn't matter. Willing to tell me what it is or not.
Guards, escort the Witcher out. And he's not to enter, not alone, not hand in hand with Hierarch Hamelfart. Honestly, he asked a question. It were a simple inquiry.
One more word, and I shall move my accounts to the competition.
Sorry, mate, but...
No reason to trouble the guards, Horst. I'll go willingly.
I don't recall giving you a choice in the matter. Kick his swiving mutated ass out.
Dickhead. Okay.
Your swords, master. Law says we're to return them. Law don't say when, though. So we'll do it, aye. Just after we beat the singing shite out of the honorable gentleman.
Aye.
Gathering place for the elite, truly. Come on, lads. Let's loosen our muscles a bit. Damn.
Whoa, hold up.
No.
Really? I'm blocking though. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Come on now, fight fair. Hit you with the two-piece and a biscuit, motherfucker.
Law says if you see someone hurt, you should summon a medic. Law doesn't say how fast, though, so you can sit tight a while.
Seems true what they say. Sword or no sword, a witcher brings gold.
Not in the mood for your peasant wisdom. Who the hell are you?
If all goes well, dare say I'm your partner.
Don't need any partners.
Oh, I don't know about that. No chance you'll lay your hands on Max Bosodi's house alone.
Really think you can help me?
We can help each other.
Get to the point, if you can.
To get this house, you need to get into the vault. And there's no way Horst will let you in there out of the kindness of his heart.
A heist? Don't like that idea one bit.
Got any others? Find the herbalist lives near Oxenfurt. Ask for some yarrow extract. You'll know why you've come.
If this is a trap of some sort.
Be seeing you, I hope.
Seems that he knows we're coming. I like that guy's armor, though. Armor is pretty dope. Hold on, before I run off, let me check this stuff out. What did I get? Look at my man Geralt. My man got some shades on, boy. Item needed to complete a quest. So where's this herbalist? Way across the freaking... Alright, let's go. I don't have to fast travel there. I can walk there. Oh shit, what the hell? Okay, wasn't expecting all this.
Nerve.
Ouch, bastard. That's kind of hurt. The hell they attack me for?
It was rather efficient.
That all you got to say? I saved your life.
Ha! Look at my man's glasses.
We'd have disposed of that rabble easily.
We?
My, I'll be precise. You know what I mean. Now, are you here to trade or not,
Know any advanced formulae? Maybe something you could teach me?
All I know, I learned from Master Grimmest of Skelliger. Looking to apprentice yourself in the herbalist trade?
Nah, I just want to learn something new.
Call it what you will. You must sail across the Great Sea. Find the Isle of Ard Skellig. There, in the sacred grove, the learned Master Grimmest will judge whether you're fit to be his pupil.
I've already learned a lot from Mr.
Let me have a look.
Grimmest. But I'm gonna look at your herbs real quick to see if I missed anything. Need the killer whale. Whatever that is. Take that. I'll take that. Troll the toxin, okay. Killer whale. Need that to stay under water longer. What does this do? Generation adrenaline points. Yeah, we'll make that too. What else we got? What is this? True. Need that. We got enhanced, okay. Got everything I need for that. Look at this stuff. Troll, Dixon, Cocktrees, Al Ghul. Don't really need that. What about bombs? Anything for bombs? Enhanced moon dust. 3-1. Superior Dometarian bombs. Oh, superior grape shot. Definitely want this. Let's see. Not enough. I like grape shot. I don't really need the Dimeterium bomb. What is that that I need? What is this? Okay. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. Let's make this. And let's get this dragon stream working. All right. Let's go ahead and talk to this guy.
Wouldn't happen to have some yarrow extract?
I do. In the back. Follow me, please.
Wow, look at all the ingredients he's got in his yard, though. Where I go, there's nothing. All kinds of stuff in his yard. Check out around here.
You've come. Good. Remains to be seen. Aim to tell me something, I think. So talk.
How do I put this? We share a goal. We both need to get into the Borsodi's vault. Both want something that's in there. Why not pool our strengths?
Sorry, but what exactly is yours?
I have a plan. Spent the last year working on it. On paper. Time to set it in motion. You one I can count on.
Who are you?
Come on. I don't even know your name.
What's that matter?
Matters because you're clearly hiding something. Not just from me, either. Wouldn't be sitting in a cellar in this shithole otherwise.
We've all some stain on our conscience. But I've not asked for your hand in marriage. Just for your help in a heist. We break it. Each take what we need, then go our own ways.
Try to trick me anyway, anyhow. You won't go anywhere. You know that? Because I'll take your head off right where it meets your neck.
I'm aware of the risks. So, now that you've threatened me and all, are you in? Or are you not?
What is
it? Before we go any further, you even know what Max Borsodi's house is?
I know it's in the vault.
Didn't answer my question.
Neither of you. Willing to help with the heist or not?
What do you want to take?
The vault. What's in there for you?
Something that was stolen.
Ought I go to the city watch, tell them a crime's been committed, not organize a heist?
I've tried. Repeatedly.
I see. Cheated by the system, wronged by the world. Doesn't matter. What did they take?
List to take a good while. So I'd rather change the subject. You in or not?
I'm no thief.
Not a thief.
It's opportunity makes the thief, Witcher. I speak from experience.
Talk.
20 Redanian soldiers guard the auction house, day and night. Patrols walk in circles around it, and here, past this corner, barracks.
Brute force is out. Gotta get in quietly.
Exactly. Not the simplest thing, though. Main entrance, armored door, windows, dimeridian bars. But not a fortress out there without a weakness. This one's no different.
Patience happens to be my weakness, so dispense with the dramatic pauses and talk.
Beside the house stands a tower from which we can enter the attic. We can't hope to enter the tower from the street on account of the patrols, but there's a window 60 feet off the ground. No shutters, no bars. We've got to get up there and sneak across to the auction house, and then down the stairs to the cellar. Crack open or blow off the bolt door, and voila.
We can go with his plan, or does Mr. Garrett have another plan? Sounds solid. Let's go with his plan.
Except, sounds like a lot of work for two.
I'm fully aware of that. For this to work, we need two more accomplices. One to scale the tower, drop us a line. The other to open the vault, a safecracker, or a demolition specialist. I've already identified some promising candidates. All we have to do is select and recruit the best among them. Also your job. I'd prefer to remain largely out of sight.
Assumed as much given your hood. Anything else?
Aye. But that's among the details, which you will learn just as soon as you declare.
Let's do it.
Don't really have any other options. So be it. I'm in. But on one condition, no one dies. That clear?
As the great son of Nilfgaard, how about we knock back around? Talk some mutually beneficial relationship.
Rather get to work. What comes first?
First, you have to assemble a crew. Then, there's the Redanian patrols to cull a bit. Too many wandering around, we could get noticed.
Culling the patrols.
It's about culling the patrols. Told you, no one dies.
Easy. I don't want anyone's death. Just need some folk to be temporarily indisposed.
Spit it out.
Jeez, Gerald, you're so mean.
To approach the garrison's cook, convince him to spy at the soldiers' nosh with something to keep some of them bedridden. One in two, I'd say. To raise suspicions.
Now the formula for a potion that might do the trick.
There. See? Brew up a bit of that. Hit the town, find the cook, then convince him to do you a favor. I don't know, cast a spell, toss him some coin. You could also use your fists.
Opening the vault. What's your options?
All right, opening the vault. Who do we have?
Let's start with the fact that one of them's a dwarf. Casimir Bassi, native of Mahakam, a specialist in controlled explosions. Folks say he could blow Novigrad to the high heavens with but a pinch of saltpeter. Bolt door for him should be a cinch.
Ooh, the problem dangerous
is,
man.
Casimir apparently hung up his detonators some time ago. He married, sired some littler ones, and settled in the village of Alvis. Might plane turn us down.
Any options?
Quinto, the North's most famed safecracker. Arrest warrants out on him in Kedwin, Lyria, Angryn, and Kavir. Certainly got nabbed a few days back by one Hans of Sidaris, a prick mercenary.
I know the man. Slew an archgriffin for him. Mean fiend, pretty much.
Hans or the beast?
Both, actually. So I'd have to rip one from his cozy home, the other from a cozy cage. Need to think about it. Break-in artists. Tell me about them. Assuming lack of vertigo to be the first requirement.
Precisely why my favorite's Eveline Gallo. A circus artist, known better as the Earl. Just now performing with her troupe somewhere near Oxenfurt. Her speciality is rhythmic gymnastics.
Breaking and entering.
Not officially, no, but I've compared the route her troupe's taken with a list of the most audacious thefts in recent years. A perfect match. Highly doubt that's a coincidence. But if she's reluctant, we've another option in Hugo Hoff, alias Beef Patty, a halfling.
Think he's fit? Pudgy face doesn't really match my image of a criminal.
You'd be surprised. Hugo's notched up more break-ins than you felled monsters. More importantly, 2 years past, he nicked the gold-plated cop from the roof of the town hall in Nova. So, yeah, man. Word has it, he's holed up in Oxenfurt in a house near the Novigrad Gate. Be careful. He's modest in size, but apparently wicked dangerous.
Alright, time was on my way.
Right, I'm off. Got a bit to do.
As do I. Get it all done, and we'll meet back here.
What then?
Then we'll bugger horse up, down, and sideways, all together.
All right. Would help if I could see. Alright, everybody, I think I'm gonna end this episode here. Remember, if you like this video, please hit that like button. And for more video content, please subscribe. Also, as said before, there is a giveaway for Royalty Gamers. Please go to www.facebook.com/royaltygamers for your chance to win Black Ops 3. Good luck, everybody. It's SwiftBoy3000, and I'm out of here.